Hello, Nana here. Oh, welcome back to Path of Exile. We are playing the Fall of Orief beta. We have arrived in Act 5 with our Viper Strike, Abyssal Cry, a Trickster. For this episode, my current plan is to actually see if we can make it all the way to Innocence in a single episode. I think I played through the entirety of Act 5, my very first time through, in about 2 hours. But I did listen to all of the lore. So I think, no, the lore is about half. So in this case, no, we're not smelling all of the roses and focusing on all of the things. So I think it might not actually be all that unreasonable to think that we can make it to the Innocence fight in a single episode, and then after that, you know, end the episode, and the next episode do the same thing, and then move our way towards the Kitava fight. So, oh, as I mentioned during the previous episode, I'll just reiterate it again. If you're looking for a playthrough that actually listens to all of the lore and things like that, then please have a look at my Slayer playthrough. The interestingly named Bug Slayer. That's on the channel here as well. That's our poison. So this episode, we're only gonna do the lore for Act 8. Okay, so we grabbed Fatal Toxins. That should amp up our poison damage quite a bit. Also, the duration helps a little bit. So our poison damage here listed is now 100 to nearly 300 for the main hand, and 100 to about 250 for the offhand. So we're doing decent damage. And that is for a duration of, I think, default 4. But we do have some duration extenders going for us. Okay, Blasphemy, Poison Gem. Okay, Elemental Reflect. Okay, so here things are getting a little more tough, and no, especially with the things like the blues we had before. And then Abyssal Cry does help us, because then, you know, you just have to take down one in order to take down all of the foes. Our energy shield is a bit on the low end. That's part of the build. We're going to focus on increasing the size of our energy shield pool next. And it's also part of a gearing, which, well, sort of self-found or no, first built in a league. It's a little more difficult to do that. So this is the league starter experience. But I must admit, no, despite not having the best gear in the world, doing pretty alright. But still learning all the layouts and things like that, so we'll be wandering around more or less just aimlessly for at least a little bit. I seem to remember having to go down and then left. I think there's probably a way through here that we just grr. Okay, then that way, to the door, to the right, X marks the spot. So of course now we know that the X marks Kitava. Okay, cast on Malikil, that was not entirely useful, but it is one of the more expensive support gems, because now costs an Alk to buy from vendors. Okay. So having Life Leech on Abyssal Cry seems to do all right here. So after the fight, oh, we are getting pretty decent at just recovering a little bit of our energy shield. Of course, the best way to recover is to not having to recover at all. Just not getting hit. Getting somewhere. Note to self, just keep the Stipmite Flask up a little more consistently, because it's really cheap to spam and it is pretty awesome in effect, because it really makes it more difficult for especially melee mobs to hit us. Especially after I use my Warcry, all eyes are going to be focused on me, so using it, it helps. Yeah, we still have the movement speed bonus on it. Hello, Overseer Crow. Yeah. But we'll just put a totem behind you and yeah, you're dead. Ooh, we got new gloves. So, which are these? Asenoth's Gentle Touch. Curse enemies with level 10 temporal change on the hits. That's pretty darn cool. Could potentially replace the aura, because we do AoE attacks. And it's level 10, I think that might actually be higher than the current one I have. So there's that as well. But of course I will lose quite some attack speed. And of course the Word of Force, which I must admit, I haven't really paid much of attention to what it does. Hey, there is the ladder. Thank you. So, Navali's here. We have Utula.
After every.
Well, as I said, we're gonna skip the lore. Ooh, wings. Ugh, these are terrible rolls. 20% on the flat ones, that's the worst you can get. And 12% is not too far near the bottom either. I think, what am I overcapped on right now? Overcapped on fire, so let's go for the cold and lightning. Now we gotta pick something, might as well pick something that's potentially useful. But of course, the game never disappoints. It's not a really great setup. So, all the stuff we find, it's just gonna go into the box. And in between episodes, I'll have a look at it. Violetta. Okay, and then Templar Court, Kill Justicar, and the Miasmeter, something. Okay, physical damage from Reflect, that should hurt us more. But not too much. This, of course, no. Leech, life gain, all the good stuff. Ooh, accidental dodge. That was nice. You throw a net, I dart out of it. Okay, slight correction on what I said in the previous episode. But I think we're much more nimble than the Slayer. And the biggest reason for that is, of course, Whirling Blades with a lot of attack speed as opposed to Leap Slam, which, though, don't get me wrong, Leap Slam is a nice skill, but Whirling Blades is just nicer. Okay, let's stick to the, let's go to the top theme. I think that is also what I did last time through. That should get us to the Miasmeter. If it was always in that location, then this is gonna help us. Thresher Claw, oh, that's what I'm using now, nice. Get another one, see if we can craft it into something decent. Because it... No, better tier, means better damage. Bye bye. Oh, scouring, that's useful. And we have a marker. So, you can use teleport moves to actually get up on the ledge here. That's not one of the reasons for actually just keeping a flame dash in your build. Because it's just very useful for the utility, and the earlier acts, now acts 1 through 4, don't really capitalize on it, but here you actually do have it. Which is something I do appreciate. Okay, experimental supplies. Alright, so just so many things dropping out. Hey, I don't think I really had a terribly great helmet, and that color combination is what I currently have in my boots, so let's actually just pick it up and switch it. Okay, now Vilenta is going to be happy with her thingamabob. I don't think it's actually plot relevant in any way, shape or form, but it doesn't really matter. Those claws might also have been useful in terms of links, link color. Red, blue, red. That's a spell totem, that's a wither, and that is a increased duration. So that would actually work as well. So now I have two alternatives for the boots. And getting red, blue, red on claws is quite a feat actually, because it's now int and dex based. So getting a green and blue variations is much more common. If I'm seeing this correctly from the corner of my eyes, then my health bar, or my energy shield bar rather, keeps bopping up and down. But I don't think it actually touches into my life. It just keeps dropping at something to like 50, and then it's gonna go up again because I'm hitting things and leeching life and all kinds of good stuff like that. Or leeching energy shield rather. And imagine this is with only 450 energy shields. Once we have an equal amount, then we should be good. Area contains many totems. We still need to get ourselves a Vile Lightning Trap for boss fights. So, gonna be glorious. What did it do? Many totems. I think I said that. And sometimes you have this thing where, no, you're reading things, you're saying things, but they're simply not registering. Oh, that was lovely. I do want to take the opportunity to just murder all these fools. Hallowed Life. That's going to be the next tier, though. Hallowed Mana. And we're going to go back down to something that recovers 40 mana per second versus 110 mana per second. 5 charges versus 10, 4 charges, okay. Alright. And another rare that's just not following me. Why are you doing that? Come on, yes, exactly. And of course, we kill the rare and then we see the ghost. That's often how it goes. Yeah, 42 area, that's why the Hallowed Life drops, because that's level 42 flask. Good thing is, if you get a full set of those level 42 life flasks, they'll last you until maps, and then the maps ones are just going to be a tiny upgrade versus a major life changer. No puns intended. Also, I do recall myself saying something about Stimlight flasks earlier, and then I don't actually use them. So let's see if I can pay a little more attention to that, and just trying to keep it up. Whenever I dive into a group, flask up. mana. It's better than the regular one. Okay, do we have new bosses yet? Okay, this is not even the boss room yet. For a moment I thought it would be the boss room. Because that's also, no, the previous act we did have placeholders, or the previous time through. No, it could be that next week or the weeks after is going to be when things like these get filled in. What splitter? Can we fit things in? I have no idea. Let's just empty pockets and make this quick. Also, while we're here, ditch those and hand this over to Valenta. A passive skill point. Lovely. Increase damage. Yeah, let's just complete the wheel. Just lovely. So that's now 300 at the top end, 314. That's gonna be pretty decent. Okay, you look Huitapa the Blind. You look new. Foul Righteous Fire. That's, yeah, one of those skills that kind of scares me. Give up all of your life and energy shields except for 1 point of life in exchange for a massive explosion. Yeah. You know, if you combine it with Vile Immortal Call, then you could do some interesting things there. Gouger. That's level 40. Then the way forward is there. This is where we were before. Bearers, but we do have a little bit of time. And then kill the Justicar. Casticus. Okay, you... What are you summoning? I have no idea, but doesn't really matter. We explode him, and then oof, look at the... His life just went zoom. I think that was because all of those little buggers just threw poison stacks on top of him. Does add. Oh, lovely. You kill one, you kill all. That's probably gonna be the theme of this build. So far I like it. Build's not even entirely complete, but the bits and pieces that are up and running, they are working pretty fine. And it's a 41 area, I am 44, so yes, I am slightly overleveled. Yeah. But that's not weird either. Okay, waypoint, so let's go back to the Overseer's Tower. Stash more things. And then the Eyes of Zeal are gonna be useful. Casticus Rewards. Yay! Step Knight, we already have it. Silver, ooh, that cast us Onslaught. Yes, please. Remove Bleeding. I would prefer it to remove the Freeze and Chill. Because now we can actually do a drop in for the Quicksilver. You know what? Let's see if we can roll this on the fly. Ha ha ha! That is lovely. 30% increased charge recovery. This is not the most ideal combination. The 25 or 23% reduced flash charges used, or plus 20 charges, those are probably better because then you actually have two sips rather than one sip, and then a need for kills. So just put this one in the bin of old stuff. And then let's continue with the Glowing Bulls. Aurea Square to the library. So now we can get to the Templar Courts. Okay, some enforcers. Rare bones, that one died rather quickly. Ah, there was ravens on the floor, or birds on the floor. I thought people turned into birds. That looked a little odd. A little reflect again, not really much of an issue. Okay, in middle of the square, I think housed a unique. Which, again, if memory serves correctly, wasn't actually doing all that impressive. So that's going to be a lovely one to see if it's any better now. Okay, lots of things exploding. Let's clean it out. Ooh, yeah, the magistrate. A matriarch, I mean. Okay, you got backup from something that's way more impressive looking than the boss. That's of course because of the extra life also increasing model size. Okay. That worked pretty well. So for boss fights like that, if you unleash the silver flask, you get onslaught, which means you get increased attack speed. And that means you can just apply your poison stacks even faster than normal. Hello there, you with your backflips. Look very fancy, but in the end, you're just gonna die like all the rest. Really. That was another level, 45. Okay, so we got this one, that's another investment into offense. Now I want to increase the size of my health pool, so we're gonna go for melding at next. And let's see. Now we're gonna hit discipline, that's also a health pool increase, wither, and temp change. Lovely. Okay, we only have one main quest right now, which is lovely. Also, ow. So, this is where the previous build felt a little more solid, because I only had, I was only tanking on life. And I think at this point I did have my Slayer Leech up and running. So all the overkill instantly granted me life leech, 20% of the overkill damage. The leech was doubled in effect rather than only increased by 50%. Oh, that's a volatile. And the most important thing is life leech did not expire from being at max level. So that way it was way easier to just keep myself at the maximum life. Also, I did have life gain on hit on my support attack puncture, which I was spamming most of the time while surrounded. Because it really allows you to just sustain at an incredible rate. Okay. Here I have to be a little bit more dodgy just to get out of the attack lines of the ranged foes. And you do see that the energy shield drops off rather quickly. But once I do start thinning out the herd, things get better. I was gonna look at something. I have no idea what it was. Note to self, we now have onslaught on the final flask, not movement speed. So please, if I were myself, don't keep chugging that flask like it will recharge. In between fights or in fights, because I need it in the fights themselves. Hello there, Templar Court entrance. Oh, 25 minutes and we're at the Templar Courts. We're doing pretty fine here, I would say. Because this is where the final fight is gonna be. Music opens up very suspenseful. I do remember the music actually having some very, very epic moments in it. I do hope the choirs and things like that will trigger, because most areas do have multiple soundtracks. Lovely, just seeing them all explode with joy. But even if they're not exploding with joy, they're still exploding quite a bit. Ah, there's the choir. Oh, something popped up behind me. Hey, hello there, Ghosty. Boom. Explode pack to kill ghost. It works. Can't say anything but that it works. Okay. Actually, I'm moving faster between packs than that the Abyssal Cry can recharge. That's an interesting thing. Ah, this is the main judgment room, I think. About the halfway point of the area, and then we should be able to leave through a side area. Lovely. Is it me, or is the sound effect from drops, does it feel slightly delayed? Might be that it always was that way, but I'm just now noticing that the visual of the drop appearing and the sound playing, there's a little bit of a delay in there that I never noticed. So another difference with the Slayer build was because I was able to... it was more of a tanky tank. This is definitely more of a nimble kind of character that has a surprising amount of sustaining power. Given the fact that it is a nimble character. No, it's a hit and run character that actually can stay around for a little bit to hit some more. Whereas the Slayer is just a very, very basic, I have nearly infinite amounts of life kind of tank. But as a result, no, I'm paying a little bit more attention, just moving around a little faster, just being a bit more focused and just dodging and playing more on reflexes. Does give me a little less time to actually enjoy the scenery. So I'm very happy that my first character was the Slayer, so I could just gape at things without too much issues. Where with this build, I'm more in the moment in the fight. Of course, it's a second playthrough as well. But this is a nice entry though, with all the stained glass panes. Definitely has a bit of a grandeur to it. Let's empty our pockets once again, then we can push forward to the final fight. Okay, so last time I went through the outer walls and then I discovered what basically shaped a little bit like a seashell or snail. So this time I'm gonna see if I can focus more on the inner walls of that seashell. In the end, not really gonna matter all that much. Okay, I think I'm doing a decent job of at least keeping my comet flasks up. Though the game is forcing me to do that. There's just a lot of damage coming in here. There's an interesting mix of ranged and damaging foes. There's some ground attacks. There's some things that mark the floor. Stained glass window. I don't think I clicked this last time. As this titan of sin rose to its many feet, Innocence knew that the village was lost. With an anguished cry, he committed it to flame. As town and titan burned, the sky turned dark with the ash of sin. There, amongst the raging ruins of his home, Innocence swore an oath. No matter where the ashes of sin fell, his purifying flames would rise to meet them. Okay. So, yeah, a bit of a link with fire, burning, cleansing, and sin being evil. Though, as what we know from the story so far, actually, sin seems to be the good guy. Question there, of course, is he truly a good guy or just a slightly less evil guy than the other ones? And will he backstab us in the end? Because, well, he does make a very typical appearance of something that usually doesn't look all that good if they're all dark and moody and brooding and things like that. Gouger, that's another one. Triumph of Innocence. Oh, let's put a couple of these and then go back. Waves crashed upon the shores of Oriath. Waves of hunger, waves of desire. The ravenous god and his starving multiple. Rising with the tide, flooding our streets with death and depravity. Until Innocence cried out, "No more!" Bathing our city in fire, scorching the wicked to ash and bone. The ravenous god fled into the embrace of our glorious savior. Driven down he was into soil, stone and beyond, into damnation, by the will and light of our innocence. Triumph of Innocence by High Templar Avarius. Wonder if they will get voice acted in the end as well. So now it's just a narrow path forward. There's no more wider areas. Definitely this is not an area where you're supposed to get lost or things like that. I figured if there was maybe a bleeding or burning removal effect on the flask and I could just equip it right away. But now it seems to be not the case. Okay, another one. The village gathered to watch Sin become ash and breathe deeply of the smoke that poured from his screaming mouth. Sin filled their lungs, their minds, and their hearts. That is interesting. Oh, burning him and then absorbing him. Interesting way of looking at it. So this is definitely the amount of damage we're taking versus the size of our health pool. We need to scale that health pool, because otherwise this is not gonna be all that glorious in the long term. Though of course, we are there. Next 4 points are gonna increase our life and energy shield. Yeah, note to self, keep the fortify up or make the fights not last any longer than 5 seconds. Of course, no. If the fortify lasts for 5 seconds and I kill them within 5 seconds, then I don't need to refresh it. Oh, more lore. So as always, now there's the difference between intention and reality, and I am picking up a little bit of lore simply because I don't remember reading them last time. Yet the punishment only served to feed Sin's lust. Before his brother's eyes, Sin stole a fish from the market and lied to the watchman who caught him. Sin then beat his brother until the promise of silence was extracted. So that is that one. And more lore. Innocence could not keep a promise made in fear. He bore witness and testimony to the mother of two, and it was decided between mother and son that Sin was beyond rule and redemption, that only purification could cleanse his burgeoning corruption. Okay, are we gonna see the final part of that story? After we grab melding on the tree, we're gonna go into the witch area to also grab the energy shield upgrades there, because they are pretty darn potent. And we're gonna grab the area of effect notes. Because larger AoE means we reach further with our warcry, the explosion is larger, and also melee splash should hit more things and therefore give me more life. Small detail, I'm still at 53% lightning resistance. So yeah, everything that deals lightning damage to me hurts a lot more. More or less double the amount that it normally would deal. Let's see, another hollowed life, just have a double check there. Movement speed. So we are at the fight. So quickly emptying pockets and then moving forward. For convenience, let's put a portal here, just in case things don't quite go according to plan. And then let's do this once again, innocence.
The world must be cleansed of impurity.
Okay, that's about 400 points of damage with that swing. Okay. Big teleported, or big telegraphed move, not a teleported move, it's a telegraph move.
Burn!
Okay.
Rise! I am the Emperor!
Okay, that's it's good for our flask charges, right? Which reminds me, flask charges, let's actually use them. I didn't need him in the fight against the boss, but against the minions, we need a little bit more sustain than we had before. Okay. I don't like you. Might have mentioned that before. Oh yeah. He doesn't lock in until much later. Okay, and he should be gone. Yeah, we got him. Okay, this is gonna be a bugger. This is gonna be a bugger. I need a statue to hide behind. Nope. Oh, let's not get hit by the melee hits there. Oh, summons, yep, sure, we can use those. Don't really quite explode with the Abyssal Cry there, that's unfortunate. Or there's just so many light effects, it's just difficult to actually make out what's happening there. Okay, he gets faster with his moving as the stages progress. He dove away, followed by lightnings. I misjudged that one. Okay. Definitely notice that we are more mobile because we can actually get out of the attack. It's just so counterintuitive is maybe the best word to describe it. But I definitely can use the flask recharge of the this stage. Give me all my flasks, and there's a player guard in there, okay, sure. Yeah, see, even the add-ons get more tricky with progress. Yeah, burning. Doing stuff. Okay, actually using the statue for a change. I swear, it wasn't in, on purpose. Yep. I got out in time and he died because of the poison stacks. Lovely. Okay. And there is our buddy, Sin. Sin, the Forgotten One. Yeah, looks pretty decent, right? Okay, so that flips the map around and is now all dark and gloomy and corrupted. And things are burning.
Once Kitava has gobbled up.
No, we have multiple rewards here. So, sleek coat for Linked, yes, please. Cool. But that was the Innocence fight. So, my first time through with the Slayer, we had more sustained power, and we definitely noticed that ball that he shoots out, that shoots out those little lightning bolts, the bullet hell phase as it's called, or as being called by the community, that was the tricky bit, and that's why I eventually died in, because I got hit and I couldn't get out in time. But a more nimble character like this, you definitely see that I can just blitz around, and even if the waves are coming, if the whirling blade moves faster than those orbs, so I can actually get out and prevent getting hit multiple times by the same wave. It was close, but we did make it through in a single go. So if this had been hardcore, we actually would have made it. It was close, but we would have made it. So that is something to keep in mind. First time through is going to be tough. And as you get used to the fight, you can better anticipate the attacks, even though, no, the second time through, it's still not going to be fluid. This just will take, you know, half a dozen attempts to really start to get a feel for the rhythm. And yeah, oh, getting your elemental resist maxed, probably a good idea. Because as I said, I do have a gap here for lightning. He used quite a lot of fire, but I wouldn't be surprised if there's some lightning hidden in there as well. But for now, this is where I'm going to leave you for this episode. The Innocence fight is a very nice halfway marker for the act, and yeah, 45 minutes, that seems pretty solid. So, thank you very much for watching, and hope to see you again next time. Bye bye.